सो टुडेज टॉपिक आर कंस्ट्रक्टर चेनी सेटर एंड गेटर। देन वी विल स्टार्ट कलेक्शन पार्ट। विल अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट इज द डिफरेंस बिटवीन एरे एंड एरे लिस्ट। विल सी एरे लिस्ट एज वेल एंड देन विल क्रिएट अ एरे लिस्ट ऑफ क्लास टाइप। ओके, लेट्स सी हाउ मच वी कैन कवर। सो मैक्सिमम एजेंडा फॉर टुडे इज दिस। ओके, I will create a project. Collection. Now I want to understand from you guys what is constructor. Any one of you can tell us. Hello. Anybody take initiative and just start explaining whatever you know about the constructor. Nobody aware of constructor? Just unmute yourself and then tell. Okay. Okay, let me tell you guys. Constructor, many things I will tell you about constructor, then we will see constructor chaining. Is same name as class name. Okay, guys, one thing I want to be very frank with you. If you have not unmuted yourself and not telling what is constructor, but sometime interviewer will ask, and then if you feel shy, then better is that make this session interactive and try to explain yourself. Like what, wherever you will be incorrect, I will correct you. This is the right place where you have to start speaking. Okay, directly in front of interviewer, he will ask some cross questions as well. Here, if you will put those, then I will ask you cross question. If you will not able to answer, then I will answer them. So if the session will be interactive, then many things will new come out, which I am not going to cover. Maybe I will be missing, but some points I get to remember by your questions only. Even weekday batch people ask many questions and I reply to them. Okay, so they every day they are getting something new. Okay. No, any trainer can explain you everything. It depends on you that if you ask questions, new things will be coming out. When I am giving lectures on suppose constructor, then I am not restricted to this topic only. If you will ask questions, something coming out from the syllabus, then still I can answer that. Like related to topic only. Means if you are asking your selenium, then I'm not going there. But new things will be coming out with your questions only, and sometimes there may be chance that you will ask some question and I have to find it out, right? Nobody is expert, so learning is what means we discussing everything. Sorry for this. Okay, so constructor is same name as class name. Okay, and constructor डज नॉट हैव रिटर्न टाइप. वॉट दिस मीन्स मीन्स जस्ट लाइक यू राइट मेथड void void m1 void m2, void इज वॉट रिटर्न टाइप, इज रिटर्न नथिंग. ओके इंटीजर m1 दिस मेथड रिटर्न टाइप इज इंटीजर. कंस्ट्रक्टर डजेंट हैव एनी रिटर्न टाइप. सेम नेम एज क्लास नेम. कंस्ट्रक्टर कैन बी ओवरलोडेड. आई विल सी आई विल लेट यू नो हाउ वी कैन ओवरलोड द कंस्ट्रक्टर. ओके वी क्रिएट ऑब्जेक्ट्स ऑफ क्लास यूजिंग कंस्ट्रक्टर. ओके दिस इज सफिशियंट दैट वी हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड एज ऑफ नाउ. नाउ द फर्स्ट लाइन सेज द कंस्ट्रक्टर हैज सेम नेम एज क्लास नेम. सो लेट मी राइट दिस. ओके एंड ओपन एंड क्लोज पैरेंथेसिस. बट देर इज नो रिटर्न टाइप. कंस्ट्रक्टर डज नॉट हैव एनी रिटर्न टाइप. सो इफ आई राइट वॉइड हियर, सो वॉट इज दिस? दिस इज मेथड, नॉट द कंस्ट्रक्टर. सो इफ एनी बडी आस्क यू वॉट इज द डिफरेंस बिटवीन कंस्ट्रक्टर एंड मेथड, देन यू विल से दैट कंस्ट्रक्टर डजेंट हैव एनी रिटर्न टाइप. ओके यू कैन से दैट कंस्ट्रक्टर डजेंट हैव एनी रिटर्न टाइप. कंस्ट्रक्टर हैज सेम नेम एज क्लास नेम एंड दिस इज नॉट रिस्ट्रिक्टेड टू मेथड्स. दिस इज रिस्ट्रिक्टेड टू ओनली कंस्ट्रक्टर. ओके सो दिस कंस्ट्रक्टर आई हैव क्रिएटेड. ओके वॉट वी से टू दिस कंस्ट्रक्टर? दिस इज डिफॉल्ट कंस्ट्रक्टर. लेट मी राइट ए कमेंट लाइन हियर. दिस इज डिफॉल्ट कंस्ट्रक्टर. आई विल कम टू दिस वाई वी से दिस इज डिफॉल्ट कंस्ट्रक्टर. लेट मी क्रिएट अ मेन क्लास. मेन इन मेन क्लास वी चेक दिस मेन मेथड. ओके एंड दिस मेन क्लास इज क्रिएटेड. नाउ यू नो अबाउट हाउ टू क्रिएट ऑब्जेक्ट्स एंड दैट. सो इफ आई वॉन्ट टू क्रिएट ऑब्जेक्ट फॉर दिस पेरेंट क्लास, देन हाउ कैन वी क्रिएट द ऑब्जेक्ट? विल राइट लाइक पेरेंट ऑब्जेक्ट इज इक्वल टू न्यू पेरेंट. राइट दिस वे ओनली वी क्रिएट द ऑब्जेक्ट. सो वॉट इज दिस? दिस इज कंस्ट्रक्टर. ओके दिस इज कंस्ट्रक्टर कॉल. नाउ लेट मी हैव वन मेथड इन साइड दिस. वॉइड m1 राइट. आई विल गिव वन लाइन ऑफ कोड हियर टू डिबग दैट इट इज गोइंग हियर. पेरेंट क्लास m1 मेथड. ओके एंड हियर इन साइड कंस्ट्रक्टर ऑल्सो आई विल राइट पेरेंट क्लास डिफॉल्ट कंस्ट्रक्टर. ओके जस्ट फॉरगेट दिस चाइल्ड क्लास एज ऑफ नाउ. आई एम क्लोजिंग दिस. ओके वॉट आई हैव डन? आई जस्ट क्रिएटेड अ क्लास विच नेम इज पेरेंट. ओके एंड टू दैट क्लास आई हैव क्रिएटेड अ कंस्ट्रक्टर विच नेम इज ऑल्सो पेरेंट बिकॉज वी नो दैट कंस्ट्रक्टर हैज सेम नेम एज क्लास नेम. ओके now what I have done, I have just written one line of code here. Okay and one line of code here inside m1 method. Now I have created object for parent class. Okay if I have to call this m1 method, then how can I call this? Object dot method name. So object is this object. Dot method name m1. ओके राइट क्लिक एंड रन दिस. यू कैन सी, फर्स्ट इट हैज कॉल्ड पेरेंट क्लास डिफॉल्ट कंस्ट्रक्टर, देन इट हैज कॉल्ड द मेथड. व्हाई द कंस्ट्रक्टर इज कॉल्ड फर्स्ट? बिकॉज यू हैव रिटन लाइक न्यू पेरेंट, राइट? सो कंस्ट्रक्टर कॉल इज फर्स्ट एंड मेथड कॉल इज सेकेंड, दैट्स वाई इट हैपेंड. ओके, दिस इज अ नॉर्मल कंस्ट्रक्टर. हियर इफ यू हैव एनी डाउट देन आस्क मी. ओके, सो दिस इज कंस्ट्रक्टर एंड ऑब्जेक्ट क्रिएशन. नाउ द नेक्स्ट थिंग इज दैट वॉट इज कंस्ट्रक्टर चेनिंग. टिल हियर वी आर अंडरस्टैंडिंग वॉट इज कंस्ट्रक्टर दिस एंड दैट. बिफोर दैट वी शुड अंडरस्टैंड वॉट इज कंस्ट्रक्टर ओवरलोडिंग. ओके, सो ऑफकोर्स यू नो अबाउट द ओवरलोडिंग. देर वॉज ए लार्ज सेशन दैट गोज अराउंड. ओके, सो ओवरलोडिंग मीन्स यू हैव मेथड्स विद सेम नेम. इन टर्म्स ऑफ मेथड ओवरलोडिंग आई एम टेलिंग हियर दैट इन टर्म्स ऑफ मेथड ओवरलोडिंग एनी वन आई विल आस्क यू वॉट इज मेथड ओवरलोडिंग एनी बडी बिकॉज वी हैव ऑलरेडी कवर्ड दैट. सो एक्सपेक्टेशंस आर दैट यू नो अबाउट दैट. या Sajni, what is overloading method of? Okay. ओके, सो दिस इज मेथड ओवरलोडिंग व्हाट यू हैव टोल्ड. सिमिलरली देर इज कंस्ट्रक्टर ओवरलोडिंग, राइट? ऑफ कोर्स कंस्ट्रक्टर ओनली वी व्हेन द क्लास नेम विल बी देयर सेम एज कंस्ट्रक्टर नेम, राइट? सो आई विल राइट वन कंस्ट्रक्टर हियर, पेरेंट. If you create same like no argument constructor, then what will happen? Error, right? If you give here suppose string name, so this is different constructor. Okay, suppose I print here name is plus name, so this argument will be printed. Okay, but one thing you should know that this is default constructor. Why we say this as default constructor? Because if you create this constructor or not create this constructor, doesn't matter. This is by default present inside your code. Okay, previously whenever I was creating the object in the previous sessions, I haven't created any constructor, still this was not error, right? So this default constructor comes inbuilt. You don't need to write it manually. If you have some manual code to write, then you have to come. Otherwise, this line is written. This is hidden. Okay. This code is hidden. Till this code, this is hidden. Okay. Means if I comment this code and I comment this code. Now you can see, still we can run this program. Okay, parent class M1 method called. Parent class M1 method. Now message was written inside constructor which you have written manual code. I hope you understand this. Okay, now what I am going to do, I just have created this. This is default. Why we said this as default constructor, I explained. Okay, now I have created a manual constructor which is have one argument as a string parameter, one string argument. Okay, now you can see one argument I have passed here, string argument I have passed here. Okay, now instead of this, if I pass here one string argument, then which constructor will be called? Constructor which have one string parameter, right? So it will jump to here. Okay, and it will call this. Name is Vandan because I have passed here one string, so it came here and inside this constructor, and then it has printed this line. Vandan I have passed, so this has calculated that variable and printed here Vandan. Then there was a method called, so it has called that method. Okay. Now there is a method which only applicable for constructors. Suppose I write here this. So what does it mean? This works for the constructors only. Right? Don't try it for methods, it will be error. Right? Now what if I write this here? So what will happen? It will go to this string type constructor because I have passed here one string type parameter. It will come here inside parent. Okay, and it will call this. What does it mean? Call constructor default constructor. Because only default constructor is the constructor which doesn't have any parameter. So inside this method I haven't passed any parameter. Okay. Suppose there was another constructor, parent int number. Number is plus number. Okay, so number is this number. So what if I pass here 10? So which constructor it will call? Parent. Okay, what if I pass here this? Then which constructor it will call? Child. Sorry, default constructor. Okay, so here I haven't passed any parameter. Let's understand this, run this program. Here I am passing Vandan. So by default it will come here inside constructor which has a string as a parameter. Okay, so it will come here. Okay, then it will find that it is calling this 10 means constructor which has one integer parameter. 10 is integer, right? So it will call this constructor which has one integer parameter. Now it will come here and again it's internally calling one constructor which doesn't have any parameter. Of course that will be default constructor, so it came here. Then it will execute this line of code. Then parent class default constructor is your first output. Let's open notepad. Then it will go back to this constructor and this line it has to execute. The number is 10 because passed 10. Okay, so next output what will be? Number is 10. then it will go back to here and execute this line, name is Vandan. Okay, then it will go back to, because this one called that line, then object dot m1, then it will call this method
parent class m1 method. Okay, now let's run it. Okay, mature result. So if you know what is the rule, then you can tell that what will be the output. Now see, there is a rule about this method. Inside every constructor, this should be in first line only. Okay, here I have a place, then I have written here. Otherwise, this should be first line of statement. If you will try to write it as second line, let's try it. Can see constructor call must be the first line of statement inside a constructor. Okay, so you cannot write it second line, third line. It should be first line of the statement. Anybody has any doubt, ask me. Otherwise, I will be moving to constructor chaining. This was constructor overloading and calling constructor inside a constructor, inside a class. Nobody has doubts. Right. Yeah, because if you create or not create, compiler is giving it to you by default. Then one more thing, that inside, if you remove this, okay, just comment this code. Okay, and if you try to call out default constructor, this rule you should know, then you will find an error. And what that error? The constructor parent is undefined. Now here is the default constructor. We said that compiler has a default constructor. Now where is that? Whenever you create any custom constructor, customized constructor for you, then default constructor killed, right? Now if you have to reuse the default constructor, then you need to create it manually by writing code. So once you create your own constructors, your default constructor killed, right? And you have to manually create it if you have to use it. So this is one rule about the default constructor that you should know. Okay, now let's up to the child. Now this was total about the constructor overloading and the this method. Now I will tell you about the constructor chaining real concept or reality of the constructor. What is constructor chaining? So this is another class. This is child class, and of course this child class will have a constructor. Okay, that is default. If you create or not create, so default constructor I have created. Now I will give you a message here. Child class default constructor. Okay, and void m2. Guys, after the collection topic we will have a mini project, okay, that I have said, and there you have to use multiple time this constructor chaining in that project. So if you miss this, take it lightly, take it for granted, then you will not able to complete this assignment. Okay, every OOPS concept will be used there. Every whatever I have taught you, every concept will be used in that project. Nothing will be missing. Everything will be there, right? So you should know everything, but majorly used concept will be this constructor chaining and array list and this and that. But if you think that any concept you are missing, we are not collecting, creating, have muscled any garbage in this course, right? Just we have collected that Java part which is necessary. Without that we cannot proceed. We have covered only that. So no concept you should take lightly, okay? So this is method m2. Just message this method m2 inside child class. Why I write like this? So that we can understand which method is called, which constructor is called, right? Now just let me create the object for the child class. Child object is equal to new child, okay, and object dot m2. Okay, so this is child class. I am calling m2 method. Okay, just simple. There is a default constructor, child class default constructor, m method m2 inside child class. Okay, this all we have called. Okay, you know about this, what's happening. Just the child class, and I have created object for this and calling this method, right? Now if I write this line, currently your output is this. When you have created the object for child class, your object is this. Now if I extend parents, means I perform the inheritance, then let's run this program and see the output. Parent class default constructor, it called child class default constructor and method m2 inside child class. You can see previous output was child class default constructor and method m2 in child class. Right, so how this parent class default constructor is coming, we have not called in this child class. We have never given any reference for this, and we know that through inheritance methods cannot be constructor cannot be inherited. So how this parent class default constructor is coming as output? Because this super is written here. Okay, this super is written here by default, and I told you this super should be the first line of the statement. Okay, if you try to write it in the second line, you cannot write it. Same error as for the this method. Okay, so this and super should be first line of a statement. Please write somewhere these rules. Practice these rules. These rules cannot be remembered. Practice can only remember this. Okay, so this and super should be the first line of the statement. Okay, now here you can see that this super is written by default. That's what it calling default constructor of parent class. Now if I don't want to call default constructor of parent class, I want to call different one, then suppose I pass here one none. So what will happen? This I am creating default constructor. Okay, then it will go to child class, it will go inside default constructor of child class. In the first line it is calling the constructor of parent class. Super refers to parent class, this refers to same class, super refers to parent class. So which is the parent class for this child class? This child class, parent, name is parent itself. Okay, so parent class default parent class constructor where one string as a parameter, one string as a parameter will come here, and here it's written this 10, so it will call this constructor, it will call this one, and this is now there is no line written, so it will go back from here. Let's calculate our output. Okay, this is constructor chaining, you should know. Let's calculate rules, we will understand, and then so execution will start from here. Child object is equal to new child. Okay, so this is default constructor of the child class, it will go here. Inside default constructor, super refers to parent class. Okay, and you are manually given one string as a parameter here. So super class constructor, we have here one string as a parameter. So super class constructor, which is the super class for this class? Parent. So it will go to parent, and one string parameter constructor. Okay, so it came here. Now first line it will find this 10, means in the same class it has to find the constructor where one integer and a parameter. So it will go here, one integer and a parameter, and there it has written system.out.println, number is number, so number is passed actually 10, so number is 10 is your first output. Okay, then it came back to here and it is printing system.out.println, name is, and I have passed name Vandan, so name is Vandan will be printed. Okay, now it will go back to here and print this line child class default constructor. And then it will call the object object.m2. Object of created of child class, so child class m2 method, this method m2 inside child class. Let's run this program. This is your result, number is 10, name is Vandan, child class default constructor, and method m2 inside child class. Okay, so if you know the rules you can calculate the output, but you don't have to calculate the output, you should know the rules. Okay, and only by writing random things you can practice this, and according to need you have to design your constructor in your project. Okay, now if let me tell you that this super is not restricted to this default constructor only. If you create like child and integer A, suppose string first name comma string last name. Okay, then you can simply write first name plus plus la
लास्ट फर्स्ट नेम एंड लास्ट नेम यू विल राइट हियर. ओके, इनसाइड दिस ऑल्सो इट हैज रिटन बाय डिफॉल्ट, यू कैन नॉट सी दिस कोड, दिस हैज रिटन बाय डिफॉल्ट एवरीवेयर. In every class, it has written by default. Sorry, not in class, inside every constructor, when you are using this extent concept. Okay, if I remove this, then it is not written because it hasn't any parent. Now you are writing like this and it's saying that the constructor object string is undefined. Okay. Means it is referring to its parent class and it is unable to find this method one string as a parameter. Why this is not getting error? Because we all know that by default every class extends the object class. Object is the top class of the Java. Okay, that's why. But this object class doesn't have any parameter as a string one parameter constructor. Okay, that's why this is getting error and super is not getting, because object class has a default constructor. Okay, so this I was talking about. So if you know all the rules, many questions will be coming at cross, you should know everything. How much he can drag and drop you, interviewer? No, nothing if you know all the rules. Anybody has any doubts in constructor chaining? Okay. So this constructor chaining is over. Setter getter I will tell you. Let's take 30 seconds break and then I'll start setters and getters. You guys can take 1 minute break, then we'll start the setter getter. Okay, so what are the setters and getters method? Let's create a class and understand that. So it has one main method. What do you guys know about encapsulation? Let's see.
मेकिंग मेथड्स पब्लिक वेरिएबल्स प्राइवेट. ओके सो दिस इज इनकैप्सुलेशन. नाउ द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन में भी व्हाट इज टाइटली इनकैप्सुलेटेड क्लास. सो इट मीन्स ऑल वेरिएबल्स प्राइवेट ऑल मेथड्स पब्लिक. नाउ वाई इनकैप्सुलेशन. दिस इज इंटरव्यू क्वेश्चन आई एम राइटिंग हियर टू अचीव सिक्योरिटी. ओके दिस इज अबाउट सम पॉइंट्स अबाउट द इनकैप्सुलेशन. ओके यू कैन करेक्ट दिस स्पेलिंग. Why we use encapsulation? Because every method, every member will be private, means every variable is private, then that variable value cannot be changed from different class. Because we know that if my variable is private, it cannot be accessed to next class. Let's understand this. Suppose I have a variable integer number is equal to 10. Okay, and my write number method sees out number is plus number. Okay, now I am creating object for this class setters getters. Object equal to new setter. obj dot. Now I want to access this number. Okay, just try object dot number. You can see syntax error, insert variable d to complete local variable declaration. This if I make this variable as public, sorry private. Okay, now you can see error change visibility of the number to package. Okay, means what we are trying to do, we are trying to access this variable here. Okay, and we are not able to access here. If we make it public, okay, and just object or number is equal to, suppose we set 50, we can set here. Okay, some syntax error is there. What is that error? The field setters is not visible. Wait, I didn't save this, that's why. Now you can see we can access this number inside different class. Object dot number is equal to 50, but right, and previously this was 10. Okay, suppose we have not set the value here, then we can set the value here as well. And if I want to print this, then what value will get? 50 for this variable. Okay, so anyone can come easily and change. If everything, suppose your password feed is private, then anyone can make a class and just go, and if he knows the class name of your project, then simply he will access that class, he will set up. So hackers normally will do in this way. We are not in that much depth. Okay, we don't know about those things, but
द थिंग इज दैट सिक्योरिटी इज नॉट हियर. एनीबडी कैन एक्सेस योर क्लास, एक्सटेंड दिस सेटर्स एंड गेटर्स एंड चेंज द वैल्यू ऑफ दिस क्लास. बट इफ आई विल मेक दिस प्राइवेट, then you can see error, change visibility of the package. So what I will do, I will make this private, okay, but I have to still I have to set the value. So what I will do, I will right click here source, generate getters and setters, number is only one field, I'll generate here and you can see variable is private and you can set here, okay, means number set you can set here like integer number, and if you want to get then this, okay. So I will call this public method, okay, set number, object dot set number, and I will pass here 50, okay, and I will right click, this is number set, and object dot get number, simple, right, and I will actually print this inside this out. I will use this to print it. Okay, just run this. Number you have set and then you get. Okay, now you cannot change this variable value, only you can use this. Okay, means whatever you will set, you will get. You cannot change anyone else's password, only you can set access is given only for setting and getting. Not updating anything else, like if this is public, you can update this. Okay, see here, this is public. Okay, what I'll do, I will write just here object dot dot number, okay, and then as 70 I will write here, this you set, okay, and then somebody else coming in between and updating it. See, means I have set my password, somebody else came and updated my password and just login. Okay, because 70 is the new password now. So this is about encapsulation. If you make it private, then see, even you cannot access this variable, how you can set this. So this is how, what encapsulation does. Encapsulation actually achieves security, but there is one drawback of the encapsulation that you should know, that if you are going for security, achieving the security, any project, anything you are going to do, even abstraction achieves the security. So if you are going to achieve security, then every time the performance of the system will be slow, right? So everywhere that my project should be secure and this security I will apply. No, you have to take care of the performance of the system as well. Every time your focus should not be security only, sometimes your focus should be performance also. That depends, actually performance dependency is everywhere. If Facebook is taking 10 minutes to log in, no one is going to log in Facebook. Many other products are in market, they will start using that. Just because of Facebook is updating their performance level day by day, some new features they are adding, innovation they are doing, you are using that Facebook. Still you are using since 20 years, right? And nobody can compete them. So that's why
if the product is good, everyone actually looking for their uses. The product is not good, nobody will use that. So simply here, if you know the security, and this is the first level of learning the security process. Encapsulation does not end here, right? But for you guys, for automation guys, this is okay. Okay, and you should know about this. Now question does not come like this. What is encapsulation? So encapsulation, making the members as private and the methods as public, behavior as public, right? Properties and behaviors are actually variables and methods. So making the variables private and methods public should be your answer. This is encapsulation. And we perform encapsulation to achieve security. The next question will be coming, then what are the drawbacks of the encapsulation? Performance of the system down, because every time to achieve the security we have to make some authentications. That's why the performance of the system is down. Then how can we achieve this? We can achieve this by making methods public and the members private. Okay, so next question, these are basic questions which can be asked from freshers, but for experienced people the question is, where you have used encapsulation in your project, where in your framework, right? Now you start, and expectation is this only. So once we will start the Selenium, we will understand this framework development, then we will understand, okay, let me tell you where is the encapsulation here, where is the abstraction here, where is the overloading here, overriding here, right? So once we will start developing the framework of this Selenium, then we will see that. So this was the OOPS concepts. Anybody has doubt? Okay, so just practice this. We'll start collection from next week. Okay, and 2.5 hour class will be each day, and next week class Saturday and Sunday, and we will cover the collection, right? So this will be the most important part of the project.